And I wanted to ask you, like, for example, the president toured Navotas and Valenzuela, and what they've seen were the pumping stations, right? Right in the middle of the flooding. A lot of the pumping stations in Navotas and Valenzuela were filled with trash. So they weren't working, or sila. Who is in charge of these pumping stations? Yun ang tinanong ko eh. Who's in charge of monitoring it every year, making sure they work, making sure walang basura? I mean, to call on the public not to throw trash, that's a given, right? But the point
Given
is, you can't rely on the public alone to make this work. Sino yun? Senate President Cheese Escudero said it's the MMDA. Because the funding for repair is given to them. Sino po ba, Senator?
meron din, kaya nga minention ko din yung MMDA budget for flood control. Pag isuma total mo, billion din eh.
Yeah, you mentioned it was, you actually quoted the figure that in 2022 it was 1.4
0.4
billion.
billion,
Yeah.
yeah. And then some 300 million and then
Yeah.
400 plus
Oo.
million. So
In 2024, close to half a billion.
yes, ito din ang gusto ko idagdag. Okay, kaya nga sabi ko nga, let's not blame climate change. Instead, wala, no, kung ayaw natin man-blame, let's start with character change. On the part of the people, sana wag magtapon ng basura kahit saan.
Yeah.
But
When you, oo.
itong nalimutan ko sabihin sa SONA ko. Isa sa mga malalaking kontrata ng local governments would be garbage collection. Di ba? Oh, so apparently, isa rin yung sa malalaking gastos nila eh. So we have to also to review all of this. Ano ba, nag-work ba yung mga big contracts nila sa or lucrative contracts din yan sa mga garbage collector eh, sa corporations. I mean, so what's happening now to the garbage collection contracts as well as programs of local government units? Kasi nga kahit na panawagan natin sa taong bayan magtapon ng basura sa tamang lugar, ginawa mo nga. Pero pagdating naman ng collection na, ano nangyari?
Oo. That's one. Now, but do you believe the MMDA, should they be the agency to monitor, repair, actually just in charge of all the pumping stations in Metro Manila? Can they do that job, or will that fall under the Department of Water?
Wala pang Department of Water eh.
Oh, if
So
magkaroon.
if magkaroon and then kasi water management sana rin ito eh yung mga ako ang idea ko sa Department of Waters from ridge to reef
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
so from beach but siguro we can include the flood control pwede pero sa ngayon wala pa kasi wala pa
Wala
talaga
pa.
Department of Waters. So sa ngayon it's MMDA unless they tell us na it's beyond their responsibilities but during the budget season we will be asking this but if not MMDA wala nang iba kundi DPWH na po yan ang susunod kasi ano yan eh that's also an infrastructure project eh so baka convergence yan dalawa tignan natin but logic tells me now it is really the MMDA. That's why we will have to ask the MMDA what happened to your flood control projects?
Yeah, because clearly that's a blatant failure and issue of negligence, right? And I mean, who's supposed to be doing that job? So that's one thing. The next one is you did talk about education and health, but let me move on to the topic of health, right? So you spoke about that the national government will be withdrawing reserve funds from PhilHealth worth more than 90 billion pesos under the fourth trigger for funding unprogrammed appropriations. So you've always felt that unprogrammed appropriations were controversial because you're appropriating them and there's no money. You said that on Head Start, right? Ang tanong, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto has said, walang gagalawin naman from PhilHealth. Parang sinagot po niya yon.
Hindi, oh, ganito, ganito nga. Ganito muna.
At ano na po ba talaga?
If we look at the SONA of the president, so meron siya mga health programs, okay? Marami doon about about the pack benefit packages of PhilHealth.
Yes.
Pinagmayabang niya, dodoble ang benepisyo sa ganito. Yung mga generics drugs ganito, the lahat, mga para ano, it's all an increase or a rise in benefit packages. Oh. Therefore, PhilHealth ang inutusan niya doon eh. Oh. Tapos, and then although he did not announce this in the SONA, but we know that there is a circular na around 90 billion, I think the Department of Finance discovered or found 90 billion daw pesos of funds in the PhilHealth na medyo, maybe they will call this as
underutilized.
And then sasabihin la, ito yung ano eh, this is the technique they thought of during the Maharlika debates eh. Yun yun eh, that Maharlika will sweep the idle funds eh, so that Maharlika will be the one to invest. Ito naman ganyan yun. So they found out 90 billion idle funds ng PhilHealth kukunin because this is the fourth trigger. Ang ginamit ko lang fourth trigger, but this is really the parang the fourth one of the four circumstances when you can now fund the unprogrammed appropriations. Yun yun. So medyo there is inconsistency, hindi ba? Hindi ba? The president announcing to the people, PhilHealth will give you all of this. Doble na yan. Tumaas na yan. And then, yung agency na yon tatanggalan ng 90 billion pesos. Hmm. But my question is ganito. Yung 90 billion pesos, subsidy, most likely subsidy from the national government, given by the national government to PhilHealth. But when the national government gives PhilHealth subsidy, that is in the nature of premium contributions of those who cannot or do not make actual contributions.
Yeah. So therefore, the bigger question is, why is it underutilized?
No, therefore members funds din siya.
I see.
That is my point. When the government gives the PhilHealth, you know, subsidy ito to pay for the premium contributions of your members who are not actually making premium contributions. Therefore members money na yon. Beyond the reach, the sweeping power of the national government, bawal na yun. Okay, why underused? Yan ang isang magandang question.
Yeah,
but
why?
Okay. Pero ganito. Number one is, this is for health, di ba? Kung let us say, wala namang claim, wag piliting ubusin. Mabuti nga may reserve funds. We are praying for a healthy nation. Eh. Mabuti nga. But of course, a lot of of our countrymen have health problems. I-review siguro nung PhilHealth yung mga packages nila. And then, you know, at tulungan yung talagang mga nangangailangan ng tulong. Kasi ang question ko nga doon is, kung meron na nga tayong universal healthcare program, automatic na membership sa PhilHealth, bakit ang napakarami pa rin lumalapit sa opisina naming mga public officials na parating it's about their hospital bills, it's about their doctor's professional fees, it's about purchasing medicines or maintenance medicines, mga ganun. So there is really something wrong. Tapos
yes, and considering there's the Universal Healthcare Act,
correct,
where
correct.
The vision of that was to give healthcare for free for all Filipinos.
Correct, pero yun na nga, it's just in the nature of a subsidy. Yan lang yun eh. We gave it a very grand name, universal healthcare, pero how covered kayong lahat? And these are the packages, so pwede kang may health concern na wala sa package eh. Then therefore these are the packages, and then these are the accredited hospitals, and these are the accredited practitioners. O di, ang dami mong problema eh. Pwede kang magka health problem, but You do not go to an accredited hospital, or your doctor is not an accredited health provider. So yun. So you will not be covered. So ganun na nangyari. So but my point is, PhilHealth was given a lot of instructions and responsibilities by the president in the SONA. Maasahan ng taong bayan yan. Let us not disable the PhilHealth by getting so-called reserve funds, kasi ayaw ko rin pilitin ang PhilHealth gastusin ang pera kahit walang dahilan gastusin. Hindi naman siya normal agency, ano siya eh, it's a health insurance fund agency. Hindi kung da kung may fund yan, we should be happy that there is a fund. Pero wag naman nila ipagkait syempre sa mga talagang nangangailangan. So from the legal point of view, sa pagkakaintindi ko, when the national government gives a subsidy to PhilHealth, this is for and on behalf of the members who are not able to contribute. Therefore, these are members' funds already.
Okay. All right. Now, my last question is, was there anything that you believe the president should have talked about in the SONA? I mean, it's very difficult to talk about everything, but you did say that he failed to address issues such as housing, traffic, and the PUV modernization program, and the national debt. Right. Some have said they would have wanted to hear the ICC, for example. So, ang daming ibang mga opinion. Pero what do you believe was an important issue that the president ignored or could have?
He did not ignore agriculture, pero parang kulang eh. I mean, puro promises, parang puro future tense pa rin ang agriculture. Kunyari, for example, i-connect natin, meron, sabi niya, yung first 1,000 days. Gusto niya palakasin yun, di ba? We feed our children sa first 1,000 days. But hindi ba for sure, although sinabi niya DOST is developing some nutritious food and drinks. Hindi ba automatically ang thinking natin sa first 1,000 days may gatas? May component ng gatas eh. Oh. Therefore we will be importing all of this kasi ang production natin ng milk sa Pilipinas is 1% of what we need.
Interesting.
So yung mga ganun sana, that's part of agriculture. So ano yung mga actual nag-distribute ng mga inahin, nag-distribute ng mga fingerlings. So, pero ano ba? Na, did it lead to improved and increased production? So yun, sana more on he mentioned agriculture, but sana more on agriculture because yun talaga, ako paniniwala ko rin, Karen, you know, even this inflation thing can be anong tawag mo doon, fought with more production in food items eh.
And then
of course yung idea about Kadiwa, I do not know why the president is, you know, so impressed with Kadiwa, but it is a discount store. It's a pop-up discount store because you cannot locate a discount store in a permanent location because advantage ng community doon, sila lang yung access sa discount store. So it's a band-aid or a superficial solution. Ang hanapin natin is yung pangkalahatang pagbaba ng presyo ng pagkain because of greater production.
So last word, Senator Pimentel, I think what should the president watch out for, considering he had a well-received SONA, right, by all sectors, but what should he watch out for to ensure that he doesn't lose his political capital in the coming months, and especially with the midterm elections coming next year?
Well, improve the quality of the persons he will be appointing. Make sure that, you know, these people have public service in their hearts, no? Hindi lang yung posisyon ang habol nila. And then crack the whip on your people, make them all ano na, make them all feel the urgency of the situation.
All hands on deck.
Okay. Again.
Especially with inflation and food prices.
Yes. Oh, kasi ito lang ha. The president announced yung ako sa akin ha, unbelievable employment rate figures. Mm-hmm. And also an unbelievable poverty rate incidence figure.
Mm-hmm.
That was on a Monday. And then 2 days later, Carina hits, super typhoon hits. So, I'm sure kahit yung figures na yon do not no longer hold 2 days after they were announced. So ano tayo, we have a lot of problems. Sabi ko at least naka one down, 99 to go. Dun sa 99 still to be, so ano lang po yung figure of speech lang po yung 99. It can be 999 other problems, but you know, siguro the president should now impress upon his people, lahat ng appointees niyan, the entire bureaucracy, na we have to act with urgency. We have to analyze what is the real problem. Sa root cause tayo tumingin. Wag na po yung mga superficial, artificial, and temporary measures.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, sir. It's been a pleasure. I do hope you return to Head Start soon. Thank you very much. Senate Minority Leader, Senator Coco Pimentel. Thank you.